Then they remembered that God was their rock, and the Most High God their Redeemer.
Rock and roll is so loved in Nashville, you know. And of course, we know that the rock of rock and roll is the Lord Jesus Christ. How about that one? We are glad. We are very thankful to get a chance to do this again. The Lord showed us and spoke to us clearly that we are to do this for His purpose. He said, go out and rescue the perishing. He said that there are prodigals, millions of prodigals that are out there that He wants to bring back in. Those that have tasted, known of the goodness of God, But somehow the enemy, ever been there, tripped up. You're not disqualified for falling. You're only disqualified when you quit. Don't quit. Because we can be made clean again by the blood of Jesus.
You might see me stumble. You might see me fall. You might see me cornered with my back against the wall. Maybe incognito. Maybe out to lunch. Maybe caught red-handed. Or maybe just a hunch. But I'm clean, clean, clean before my Lord. Clean, clean, clean before my Lord. Like a spotless lamb. So many voices telling me which way to go.
You will be tested by the words of your mouth, by the way. So let them be right. Say what God is saying. Say what he's saying. Hey, devil, this is what God's saying. I am more than able to conquer. I'm more than a conqueror. Come on, somebody. Don't get me started. Well, I got a second chance. I don't know about you. I am getting more and more. I'm getting the second wind that I had prayed for, and I pray that for you. Woo!
Hey. How you doing? Got a couple of stories to tell you. One thing, just FYI, might be of interest to some of you. This is special tonight a little bit because I used to live here in Hendersonville. As a matter of fact, I used to live just about, 300 or so yards over this way, I think, or this way. I could see this place from where I lived, and that's the house where I wrote most of the songs that we're doing tonight. So I don't know the people who own the house now, but if you all show up and say, we want to see the room that, you know, Bob wrote in, I'm sure they will call the police very quickly. Another thing, some of you may have noticed that this looks like the stage that we had back in Beat the System. Well, it is the same stage. And we got to tell you about that story, because you're not going to believe this. So when Greg left Petra, he got the stage, took the stage with him, and he was storing it for a while and got a little expensive. So he asked this church he knew down in Texas if they, you know, had anything they could do with it. And they said, sure, you know, we can set it up and use it with our youth group and that sort of thing. And so bring it on down. So he brought it down there, and then the guy says, now, if you ever need this again, just let me know. Just, you know, call me up. So 25 years later, the phone rings, and the miracle is the same guy is still there. Okay? Now, any of you that's ever been in a church or anything knows how unusual that is right away. So the same guy is still there. He says, yeah, we got it. Just come down and get it. So we did. And there it is. Let's give the stage a hand. Come on. Let's hear it for the stage. Oh, come on. That's it. Yes. All right. And it's just been really neat to get together again. We've had lots of laughs and fun. We've had fun. We were allowed to have fun. We read about fun in the Bible, and we tried it, and it works. And the joy of the Lord is my strength. And we've just been reminiscing and having a great time, and we hope that you will enjoy being with us here tonight and sharing a historic moment of us playing together again for the first time in 25 years. So, without any further ado, we're going to do a song that's very special to us, and we hope it's special to you. Thanks.
Somebody say, Lord,
Lord,
I need more power, to love you, and to serve you, with all of my heart. Now, I guarantee you that is a prayer that he will answer. You may be seated.
Give
the message you have heard. More power to you. When we're all in one accord, thing that wait upon the Lord, they shall renew. They shall renew.
For the power to love you and serve you with all my heart, because that seed that he's planted in there can't fail. Oh yeah, it'll be tested, but it can't fail, so just keep going. That's just the point. You just keep going. Somebody say, just keep going. Somebody say,
just keep going.
That's what we got to do, and we're going to do it tonight.
This next song is very, very special to me. Back in 1983, we had sung this song every night, many consecutive evenings performing this song. On one particular day, in April 1983, I attended my mother's funeral. And after catching a couple of commercial planes and barely making it to the concert that night, we performed this song again. I'll tell you, it's Grave Robber. And this song took on a very special meaning. And very profound effect on my life. And when this opportunity came around to be with this ministry again, we're in the studio cutting tracks, and of course this song has to be on our first classic album. My father, who had been in the ministry for over 50 years, he was 92 years old. He went on to be with the Lord about a month ago. And I called up Bob. I said, hey, send me a file of Grave Robber because I want to sing this song at my father's funeral. And it was a very special opportunity to minister to my family and the congregation, the last church where he pastored. And again, it just took on a whole new level of what it meant to me and the profound meaning of this song. If you've lost a loved one, you know they're in Christ, you know where they are, you know you're going to see them again, you know that our Lord and Savior one day will overcome once and for all the grave. The grave is going to lose its bite, it's going to lose its sting, it's going to lose its power over every one of us. It's Grave Robber. Thank you.
Father, we thank you that we have an anchor. And we know that those that you called, you gave power and you gave strength to finish the race. And we thank you for those that have gone on before us that have taught us lessons that we needed to learn to get where we're going so we can finish that race strong too. We thank you that you hold the keys to hell and death, and that you will bring forth fruit in its season. In Jesus' name, amen. Give God some praise, church. Did I say church? His name is Adonai, master of the earth and sky.
You alone are worthy, and all night.
higher than I.
Testify to I say a word, I want you to tell me first the first thing that comes to mind. Lou Weaver.
Wow. Yo, Adrian!
Well, Louie and I have been buds for years. I actually knew him before Petra. And wild and zany. That's Louie.
Okay, so tell me about Louie Weaver.
Louie Weaver. Oh, man. Again, he's always up.
Mickey Mouse.
Mickey Mouse.
That's the first thing that comes to mind.
The Groove Meister.
He has a very bubbly personality.
Louis, I mean, what can you say? He's just, you know, solid guy, solid drummer. He's been, he was with Petra for so many years of those early years.
We've always been close friends, I mean, through all this. So, I mean, I love you, man.
John Lowry. Brilliant.
John Lowry.
Genius.
Ted.
I think he's the best keyboard player that I've ever seen.
Every time I get with him, it's like my mind expands because he has a great grasp on everything in the whole deal.
Mark, focused, regimented. He's the kind of guy that he's got his day regimented and he's organized. And I really respect that because I don't have that ability.
Mark Kelly.
Happy dancer.
A true man of God. He is so steadfast. He brings joy into my life because he's always Mark.
I think PK, that's what
he
I think
is a
of
PK,
Mark.
Yeah.
You know, man of God, just, you PK. Know, his whole family in the ministry.
I'm thinking back, I don't think Mark and I, in all the years when we toured and since, have ever had an argument. He just laid back, Texas, you know, and that's the way I see him.
Bob, what about Greg?
What, I mean, you know, incredible voice, incredibly unique in his voice.
The most true friend I've ever had in my life, and the most supportive man of God that God could have put in my life.
Greg, I think, is very intelligent. I think he's a brilliant person. He has a gift of gab.
Always up. Always up. It doesn't matter. When I'm down and I want to be left alone, he's up. And whether I want him to bring me up or not, he's still going to bring me up.
He's great in front of a camera. I'm not. I'm the technical guy that kind of hides in the background. And I go, yeah, I go, those guys really talk great. You know, let me do some soldering. But Greg and a good friend.
I see a changed man. I see somebody who has been through the desert with God. And, yeah, I just see great things ahead.
Bob, solid as a rock, man. Solid as a rock. Best songwriter I've ever known.
What about Bob?
Mister?
What about Bob?
Hey, what about Bob?
Baby steps.
Baby steps.
Baby steps.
The best songwriter I've ever sat down with and know is a great friend.
Introspective, focused, really deep. And I respect Bob for that. That, to me, epitomizes Bob.
Every song he's ever written has been a Bible study, a Bible lesson in and of itself.
The best writer that I can have ever worked with, obviously. Funny, which you probably are aware of at this point. And it's just good.